the Lawn Gnome, and welcome to another DCAU update. If you are new to my channel, let me just say welcome. It's a pleasure to have you. And for all of you returning, I'm sure that you are excited to talk about another DC animated film. Of course, this time around, we're dipping back into the archives and pulling one out that we actually haven't talked about. It's one of the first ones that was added to this library when it started out in 2007. This one actually came out in 2008 because a certain comic book movie came out in theaters and just destroyed the box office and wowed fans around the world, and that, of course, was the second installment of the Christopher Nolan Dark Knight trilogy, The Dark Knight. And, of course, you guys have recently seen me talk about all three of those movies on my last fandom feature, but today I wanted to incorporate the animated bridge between Batman Begins and The Dark Knight, and that, of course, was the animated film Batman Gotham Knight. This one, of course, sees Kevin Conroy return to voice The Dark Knight himself, and it was definitely a bold move considering what the topic of this film was. This was a six interlocking story movie which features The Dark Knight, Christopher Nolan Batman, in a Japanese anime style, which is actually something that had never been done before. It's quite amazing to believe that with the impact that anime has had on popular culture in the last 20, 30 years, it's incredible to know that Batman was never incorporated in that kind of medium. So using a lot of different anime artists, we got these six interlocking stories that take place in between the two first Dark Knight trilogy films. So right off the bat, I'm gonna say the following. It is definitely an incredible piece of film to watch because the animation is absolutely stunning. It is also really nice to see some different pieces of this specific Batman world actually incorporated. Besides seeing Batman progress as a vigilante of the streets, it was great to see some other Batman villains show up in this film, as well as seeing some familiar faces that we saw in the first Batman movie, but also be introduced to a few that we would actually see in The Dark Knight, including Detectives Ramirez and Archer, as well as Maroni and the Russian. So it was really cool to actually see the Warner Brothers Animation Studio give a little bit of a helping hand to Christopher Nolan's trilogy. However, I will say that this is not one of my personal favorite films. Granted, like I said, it is an amazing piece as far as production value is concerned, but I just wasn't on board with this entire film. Also, because of the fact that it's six short films, some are actually better than others. My personal favorite, and I actually discussed this in a very old episode of my DC Animated Live show with Brian Lomax, and that was the short film Working Through Pain. And the most interesting thing about that specific short film is the fact that Batman never puts on the cape and cowl. He is just Bruce Wayne on his travels. I mean, you do see him in his cape and cowl because it is a continuation story, but it's a flashback to when he was actually over on the other side of the world, and this was also before he met up with Ra's al Ghul and the League of Shadows. It was just him trying to hone his inner strength to prevent himself from taking on the burden of pain if he is in fact going to be encountering a massive amount of villains at the same time. He also befriends an outcast who happens to be his teacher in regards to these methods, and it's definitely a very interesting story looking within yourself and trying to find that inner strength. I also love the last film that features Deadshot, and I also really love the way that Deadshot was designed. We also got Killer Croc in one of the shorts, but I really didn't find that to be very believable. Granted, the Scarecrow was in it as well, and they really did pull from the lore and the comics of Batman to talk about Killer Croc, but when you take a look at the history of the three Christopher Nolan films, he had made statements about how this specific Batman cannot really incorporate himself in other parts of DC lore. And it's not just outside of that. Within Batman's lore itself, you can probably say the same thing, because when you take a look at the atmosphere, the realism of this Dark Knight trilogy, Killer Croc, and the true fantasy horror elements of Batman's world really just don't seem to fit. So that was a perfect example. I also really didn't care for the first one, which is called Have I Got a Story for You. It was a take on an old Batman the Animated Series episode, but the animation again is good, and that's pretty much my overall feeling towards this film, along with the fact that I really didn't care for Kevin Conroy in this movie. I love Kevin Conroy. He is the voice of Batman. But in this specific animated film, I just didn't find his voice matching with the style of animation that this Batman was incorporating. What I really wish they would have done was to bring the actual actors from the films and have them voice these characters. I think that Christian Bale voicing Batman would have been great. Morgan Freeman voicing Lucius Fox would have been great too. Gary Oldman voicing Lieutenant Gordon, that would have been great too. Michael Caine voicing Alfred, but we didn't get that. And that's why I just really couldn't find the way to truly fit this specific film set into the live action films. It just didn't fit perfectly. It fit to a degree because they incorporated the Christopher Nolan films so well. It was obvious that you could tell that these were part of this specific world, but it just wasn't the perfect fit. However, if you are a fan of the Christopher Nolan trilogy, if you are a fan of anime, and of course, if you're a Batman fan, you might find this to be a better, more innovative gem than I do in this animated library, and also in the Batman film library in general. Once again, I'm not saying that it's the worst film in the bunch, I just didn't really connect with it as much as others, but I do give DC Animation amazing props, because to do something so bold like this, especially incorporating it into an even bolder live-action Batman world, fantastic. Kudos. Great job on doing that. So that is my take on Batman Gotham Knight. Please leave your comments in the box below and let's discuss, and I will see you in the next one. Hey, thank you so much for stopping by my channel today. If you're new here and want to see more of what my channel has to offer, please click on the link to my last video or hit that subscribe button to be kept up to date with all of my uploads. Content of all sorts is posted here quite often, so trust me, you do not want to fall behind. I will see you in the comments, and actions speak louder than words.